डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
हेलो फ्रेंड, वार्म वेलकम इनटू द चैतन्य स्टूडियो ऑफ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम डॉक्टर अजय पटेल एंड आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग द साइबर सिक्योरिटी, प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ साइबर सिक्योरिटी। फ्रेंड, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द साइबर किल चेन। सो व्हाट इज द साइबर किल चेन? एक्चुअली वी आर फैमिलियर और द साइबर किल चेन इज द वेरी सिमिलर और इन अदर वर्ड वी कैन से इट्स डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द मिलिट्री किल चेन। सो ओरिजिनली द कंसेप्ट is used by the military to define the step an enemy uses to attack a target. So these are the defense step to prevent from the attack. Actually this concept, the concept first it was conceptualized by the Lockheed Martin in the paper which was released in 2011. So it's a similar concept to the military model. We can say it defines the step used by the cyber attackers in today cyber based attacks. The theory is that by understanding each of these steps, defender can better identify the and stop attackers at the each of respective stage, the more point at which you can intercept the bad guy, the better chance you have to deny them from their objective or force them to make enough noise where you can more easily defect them. So this is the concept like a familiar joke is there. As a teacher to whom you need to choose the class monitor, so who would be the monitor of class? The most mischievous student should be monitor of the class because he knows all the tactics to make noise or to distract the class. But if what happened, the teacher assigns a duty to maintain the silence into the class to him, because now as a class monitor he is responsible to maintain the silence in the class. So he has to act accordingly, but the advantage is that he knows each and every tricks through which generally the bad boys are distracting the class or breaking the silence of the class. So he can easily deal all these bad elements. He can easily handle all these bad elements. So same thing, to understand the attack, to understand the attacker's steps from the micro level can be helpful. Definitely it can be helpful to handle the attack. So this is the concept of kill chain. So in this methodology, first of all the defense team needs to understand the attack, how the attacker launch the The how the attackers launch the attack is very important to understand in the cyber kill chain method. So, as per the Wikipedia, the traditional military kill chain includes the multiple stages, which are listed below. F2, T2, EA. That means find, fix, F2. Locate the target, find the target, fix the location, make it difficult for them to move. So, find the attackers, attack their target and make it difficult for them to move. Then after track, monitor their movement, target, select an appropriate weapon or asset to use on the target to create desired effect. Then after engage, apply the weapon to target and assess, evaluate the effect of the target, including in any intelligence gathered at the location. So, this is the conventional military kill chain concept. Now, if we are discussing the cyber kill chain, that means it is, we can say, up to very extent, very similar to the military kill chain, like first of all reconnaissance, that means identify or gather some information before the attack about the attacker, weaponization, delivery, exploitation, installation, command and control, and actions on objective. So, this is the Lockheed Martin's cyber kill chain model. And if we look into the detail, so first of all, because to neutralize the cyber attack using cyber kill chain model, first one is reconnaissance. That means the attacker gathers the information on the target before the actual starts. So, attacker not start the attack randomly. First of all, they are the gathering information about the target. And the many security professional feel that there is nothing that can be done about this stage. So, because what happens, just simply for example, if you are the network administrator and your antivirus or your firewall reports some intrusion, and parallelly it also reports that all these activities have been blocked. That means as a network administrator, you cannot take it as a lightly. You should investigate. You should study the attack pattern. Then after, based on your intelligence, you should try to derive the attack pattern, and you need to try to derive some information regarding the attack. That means what is the source for the same location, was there any attack earlier, what they tried to compromise. Of course, due to the powerful antivirus or powerful firewall, they could not succeed. But as a security person, as a cyber security professional, you need to understand the attacker's behavior, attacker's mindset. They may also try to gather intel through the techniques such as calling employee, email interaction, dumpster diving. So once they fail to directly penetrate into the attack, they might call your employee and might ask for the remote access of the system. So this is also possible. This is where secure behavior can have a big impact. An aware workforce will know they are the target and limit what they publicly share. They will authenticate people on the phone before they share any sensitive information. They safely dispose of and share sensitive documents. Does this totally neutralize this stage? Absolutely not. But then again, no control fully does. However, this can put a big dent in attacker's capability to gather the information. A properly trained workforce can report suspicious activities such as odd phone calls, probing for more information. Then after, next is a weaponization. The cyber attacker does not interact with the intended victim. Instead, they create their attack. For example, the attacker may create an infected Microsoft Office document paired with a customized phishing mail, or perhaps they create a new strain of self-replicating malware to be distributed via USB drive. There are few security controls, including security awareness, that may impact or neutralize the stage. Unless the cyber attacker does some limited testing on the intended target. Now what happened, friend? Weaponization, that means recently, that means this is a recent incident reported in Bangalore, because as we know, Bengaluru is the IT hub of India, and there was a company, and company employee used to had a lunch in a nearby restaurant. So the lunch time was fixed, and so many employees, that means employee from the various project and various departments, around 150 plus employee, were getting a lunch in a neighboring restaurant. Now what happened, on a specific day, a team visited this restaurant. In this restaurant, they asked to fill certain kind of information. Based on that information, they offered a pen drive as a gift. So as we know, because it's a free and it's a gift, so the human mindset to attend the quiz, actually the quiz was meaningless, but the free gift, the pen drive supplied as a free gift, bundled with the spyware software. Now what happened, many of the employees were tried to use this USB drive with company's machine, but due to the policy of company, they could not. But they fixed this USB with their home laptop or home desktop, and frequently they use these USB drives for their personal purpose. Now, the incident was like, some of employees were made from their home desktop or home systems to the companies, means they accessed their organization email ID from their home network and they sent few mails. Now what happened? All their email contacts from the official email ID received number of malicious number of emails from their official email ID in which content is like that allegation towards the client, defamation for the particular organization. So this is the case particular for this kind of attack. You need to provide or you need to provide define some weaponization mechanism. Next, delivery, transmission of the attack to the intended victim. For example, this would be sending the actual phishing email or distributing the infected USB drives at a local coffee shop or cafe, while there is an entire technical industry dedicated to stopping this state. People also play a critical role. While people are on profession remembering lots of new information, they are very good at being adaptable. They generally follow this does not seem right instinct. In addition, the 2019 Verizon DBI found password and phishing as two primary attacks vectors, both involving people. As such, it is people and does not technology that are first line of defense in detecting, stopping many of these attacks, to include new or custom attacks such as CEO fraud, spear phishing. In addition, people can identify top attack that most technology cannot even filter, such as attacks over the phone. A trained workforce greatly reduced this attack surface area. So the attack delivery, transmission of attack to the intended victim. So first of all, to identify the victim, and then after, the attack delivery is also important. So to neutralize cyber attack possibility in your organization, you need to provide or you need to aware your employee to avoid this kind of practices. Then after, exploitation. This imply actual denotation of the attack, such as the exploit running on the system. Trained people ensure the system they are running are updated and current. They ensure they have antivirus of running and enable. They ensure that any sensitive data they are working with on secure system, making them far more secure against the exploitation. So it is very important to make the employee sensitized about the possibilities of this kind of data. So these are the some proactive measures, because if the employee's antivirus is updated and it is in enabled mode, that means it's running in the background, the systems or we can say the softwares though they are using are latest version, they are using the latest version softwares, that means the possibility of the attack can be minimized. Then after, installation. An attacker installs malware on the victim. Not all attack requires malware, such as CEO fraud attack or harvesting login credential. However, just like exploitation, when malware is involved, a trained and secure workforce can help ensure they are using secure devices that are updated, current, and have latest antivirus enabled, which would stop many malware installation attempts. In addition, this is where we begin to go beyond just the human firewall and leverage the human sensors. A key step in detecting an infected system, it is to look for abnormal behavior. Who better to detect abnormal behavior than the people using system every day? So, first of all, just to form the human firewall. Because if people from your organization will understand the probability regarding the risk, if they are sensitized enough regarding the risk, then you can form the human firewall, and with the help of them you can neutralize the cyber attack. Then after command and control, this implies that once a system is compromised and or infected, the system has to call home to command and control system for the cyber attack to gain the control. This is why hunting has become so popular. They are looking for the abnormal outbound activities like this. So, if the system is compromised, you have to make the system into the isolation mode, because through the infected system or through the compromised system, the attacker or the hacker can easily command your system and control the system. So, isolate this kind of system and then after try to neutralize or the cyber attack. Next, actions on objective. Once the cyber attackers establish access to the organization, they can execute actions to achieve their objective. So, you need to understand their objective based on your experience. Motivation vary greatly depending on the threat actor. It may include the political, it may include the financial or military gain. So, it is very difficult to define what those action will. For example, if attacker group belongs to the country which is rival country of your country, at that time you need to understand. Or for example, there are so many occasions in which attacker launch the proxy attack. Proxy attack, that means the attackers, those who can, to whom we can see, to whom we can understand, are the ghost dummy attackers. But the real attackers are the ghost attackers. We cannot see, we cannot identify. So, trained workforce from human sensors embedded throughout your organization can vastly improve your ability to detect and response to an incident, vastly improving your resilience capability. In addition, secure behaviors will make it far more difficult for a successful adversaries to pivot through the organization and achieve their objective. Behaviors such as the use of strong and unique password, authenticating people before sharing sensitive data, or reviewing the last login are some of many behaviors that make the attacker's life far more difficult and result in the being far more likely to be detected. So, this is the we can say conventional concept of cyber kill chain model. In a cyber kill chain model, generally as we discuss from the information gathering regarding the attacker to the actions and objective, each and every step, like weaponization is there, installation is there, each and every stage is very important. Then only you can effectively neutralize the cyber attack. For example, if you are getting some intrusion, because from your experience you can differentiate the attacker categories. So the attacker, if you could identify the attackers are belongs to the attacker category, those who are interested for the financial benefit, in that scenario you can easily prevent, or you can easily improve your practices in terms of providing more security to financial resources, providing more security to your data, your customer data, providing more security to your financial transaction through the outsider world. So all this kind of action could be beneficial to neutralize the cyber attacks. So friend, in this session we discuss regarding the cyber kill chain model. Actually, as we discussed, the cyber kill chain model is derived from the military kill chain model, and by adopting these 7 steps, we can minimize, or we can effectively neutralize the cyber attacks. Okay friend, thank you very much. And I would like to conclude this discussion here. Thank you friends. Swadhyayah par.